Hello students, a warm welcome to Orient MDS. So the topic that we are going to see today is about a functional appliance called twin block. So twin block is a functional appliance which corrects the position of the mandible, and it is a two piece appliance. This two piece appliance given by Dr. William Clark in the year 1977, and Dr. William Clark hails from Scotland. And under which category does this appliance comes? So we know that the classification of myofunctional appliance by Dr. Tom Graber. So this appliance is both tissue bone and tooth bone. So it comes under the category of Group B functional appliances according to Tom Graber, and according to mode of force transmission it comes under Group 2 appliance. What is a Group 2 appliance? So these are the myofunctional appliances which first reposition the mandible anteriorly, then the forces are transmitted to adjacent structures. So these appliances first reposition the mandible and the resultant forces gets transmitted to adjacent structures. So in case of twin block, when the patient wears the appliance, the mandible gets repositioned anteriorly in case of correction of class 2 malocclusion, and the resultant forces are transmitted to adjacent structures. So this comes under the group 2 category under the mode of transmission of the force. So before going to working philosophy of twin block appliances, let us get to know some basics of the bone physiology. So what are the effects of force on the bone? So unlike other connective tissues, bones are plastic in nature. What do we mean by plasticity of bone? So when we apply external force, which can be either compressive or tension force, what happens is the bone gets remodeled. So what do we mean by remodeling of bone? Remodeling is nothing but in some places there may be deposition of the bone, in some places there may be resorption of the bone. So simultaneous deposition and resorption is called remodeling of the bone. So this remodeling of the bone takes place according to the load or the force or the function that is kept upon the bone. So these are nothing but functions. So this compression or tension or pressure can be of any function such as mastication or chewing or breathing, talking, any way it can be of any mode of function. When it is kept upon the bone tends to change its shape by means of remodeling. So the internal and external architecture, so both the internal and the external architecture of the bone tends to get changed by means of remodeling in response to the function. So here the bone is formed. So the form is altered, or the form of the bone is altered in response to the function. So here we can tell that the form follows function. So this terminology was given by a doctor called Van der Clark, which was then expanded into functional matrix hypothesis by Dr. Melvin Moss. So always the form can be a bone. So the shape and size of the bone gets altered in response to the function. Function can be either load or pressure or compressive stress or even mastication or chewing. So these are the functions. So in response to the function, the form of the bone tends to get altered. So this is called form follows the function, right? Here upon the stress or upon the function, the internal and external architecture of the bone tends to get changed by means of remodeling, and this is called as Wolff's law of transformation of the bone. Wolff's law. So what Wolff's law states? That Wolff's law states that the internal and external architecture of the bone tends to get remodeled upon the stress acted upon it, or upon the function acted upon the bone. So this is called Wolff-Lauf transformation of bone. So this is the basic physiology of a bone in response to the function or the pressure or tension. Okay, coming to twin block technique, what do we have here? Here we are having occlusal guide planes. So according to Dr. Clark, he tells that occlusal forces, that is, for example, in case of mastication, we'll be having the occlusal forces, and this occlusal forces acts as natural functional force. So this natural functional force, that is occlusal force, which when acted upon the dentition, they get transformed to or transferred to the underlying supporting and basal bone. So we'll be having dentition, and when we have occlusal forces, it acts upon dentition and it gets transferred to dentoalveolar bone and basal bone. So what happens after this? So according to Wolff-Lauf transformation of the bone, when the forces tends to go to dentoalveolar bone and basal bone, they undergoes remodeling in response to the occlusal force. So this is the basic premise of working philosophy of twin block appliances. So natural occlusal force, like from mastication, tends to get transferred to dentition, and from dentition it goes to dentoalveolar bone or supporting alveolar bone, and from there it goes to basal bone, where it undergoes continuous trabecular or internal external architecture changes. Thereby it forms adaptation to the occlusal forces. Okay, in normal development, this is called inclined plane or cuspal guide plane. So in normal, assuming we are having normal development of maxilla and the mandible, so in normal development, this cuspal guide plane determines the relationship of dentition. So we'll be having class 1, class 2 and class 3 molar relationship. So how they have been formed? So they have been determined by cuspal guide planes in response to the development of soft tissue and hard tissue. So let us assume we are having a class 2 mal occlusion. What is class 2 mal occlusion? We'll be having mesio occlusion in case of molar, that is, we'll be having the distal buccal cusp of maxillary molar occluding in the buccal groove of lower first molar. So this is called class 2 mal occlusion. How this is developed? So the etiology of class 2 can be either skeletal or dental, or both skeletal and dental. So assuming that we are having a skeletal mandibular retrusion or skeletal mandibular retrognathism, which would have contributed for class 2 mal occlusion. So now according to Clark philosophy, now we are having distal occlusion. Okay, so in case of distal occlusion, what we have, we'll be having occlusal forces from the cuspal guide planes in distal direction. So we'll be having distal driving component. So what happens after distal driving component is, this occlusal or distally directed forces locks the mandible distally. So it won't let the mandible to grow mesially or anteriorly, which will worsen the mal occlusion. So class 2 will be fully established. So the distal component of the force from the developing mal occlusion causes the mandible or locks the mandible in posterior position or retroverted position, thereby establishing full-fledged mal occlusion. Now what twin block does? So this is the pictorial representation of twin block appliances. So here we are having twin block. Twin means two. So we'll be having two blocks, one retained on the maxilla and one retained on the mandible. So these twin blocks, they perfectly modifies the occlusal guide planes or cuspal planes. So once the patient wears the appliance, patient will be repositioning the mandible in forward manner, Thereby, the Kuspal guide planes, which was before digitally driving, now gets altered with the help of appliances. So when it gets altered with the help of appliances, a new function is established. So previously in this slide, we are having a distal component of force because of the distal occlusion of the molar. Whereas when after wearing the appliance, a new function, this is very important, a new function or a new sensory engram is established. A new sensory engram is established, and now we have repetitive proprioceptive stimulus. What is repetitive stimulus? And this appliance is intraoral appliances, and this appliance is meant for 24 hours wearing. So this appliance is meant for continuous wearing. So having this appliance in the patient's mouth, when the patient is doing mastication or chewing, a continuous tactile pressure is being exerted upon the newly formed position. So after repositioning the mandible, when the patient is having this appliance, a continuous tactile force in the form of mastication is being acted upon. So what happens? The underlying bone learns to adapt to the newly formed position. So previously the mandible was placed back, and after placing the appliance in the patient's mouth, the mandible assumes a new position. So a new function is established, or new sensory engram is established, over which a continuous proprioceptive stimulus is being acted upon in the form of mastication, given that this appliance is 24 hours wearing schedule. So what happens in the underlying bone, both dentoalveolars and supporting basal bone, tends to learn the newly accommodated mandible position, and they undergoes remodeling. Thereby, the whole mandible undergoes a total remodeling, thereby assuming a new shape of the mandible. So this is the basic working philosophy of twin block appliances. Now this phenomenon is very important in case of twin block appliances. So this phenomenon is called pterygoid response. So what is pterygoid response? So once we advance the mandible in case of twin block, why the mandible is getting advanced? Because with the help of constriction bite, we'll be repositioning the mandible anteriorly in case of class 2 div 1, and we'll be fabricating the appliances. So once the patient wearing the appliances continuously, what happens is like, there will be a formation of tension zone in retrodiscal area. So this is articular eminence. And this is mandibular fossa or glenoid fossa. So having the mandible positioned anteriorly because of the appliance, there will be formation of some soft tissue or tension zone in retrodiscal area or posterior to the condyle after wearing the appliance. So what is the significance of this pterygoid response? So when the patient putting the appliance, when the patient tries to accommodate or tries to learn or having accommodated the new position of the mandible, and assuming that when the patient is removing the appliances, what happens is like, mandible tends go back in the normal direction or the previous direction. So when the patient removes appliance, the mandible tends to go back in the previous or pre-treatment position. So now after putting the appliance, a newly tension zone is being formed. So when the mandible tends to go back, the mandible or condyle hits this tension zone and patient will feel pain. So this is the importance of pterygoid response. Once the patient feels pain, he or she again tends to posture the mandible forward. So a continuous forward positioning of the mandible is established because of this pterygoid response. So what is pterygoid response? It is nothing but a formation of tension zone in retrodiscal area posterior to condyle upon wearing the continuous wear of twin block appliance. So when the patient removes appliance, the mandible tries to assume its normal position. When such maneuver is happening, the condyle tends to hit the newly formed tension zone. In that time, patient will experience a pain. So when the patient experiences pain, he or she again tends to push the mandible forward, which is required for correction of class 2 division malocclusion. So this is called pterygoid response. So now we have a special segment called Auden Flash, which summarizes everything that we discussed right now. So how twin block works? So the malocclusion will be developed either because of skeletal or dental or soft tissue factors. So when such thing happens, it leads to unfavorable cuspal guidelines. For example, we are having distally driving component of force, which locks the mandible in posterior direction or distal direction. So unfavorable cuspal guidance provides a repetitive tactile stimulus which alters the trabecula and it forms deterrent structure of the bone. So after giving twin block appliances, this appliance alters the cuspal guidance and it helps the mandible to assume a newly formed position. So now optimal occlusal guide plane and forces are established with the newly formed or newly established mandibular position, which forms a sensory engram, and the underlying bone tends to adapt this newly established function and sensory engram, where the bone gets remodeled and optimum growth of bone is achieved. So this is the basic working philosophy of twin block appliances. So my dear friends, I hope this session was very useful regarding the working philosophy of twin block appliance. Thank you.